So down the hole is 500 kilograms of explosives, and then on top of that is it's about 40 meters of gravel, and when it goes off there'll be a bit of water as well that'll geyser out. So the energy will be directed down, so the waves travel out and reflect off all of the strata that are in the crust, and we're after one particular key reflector that's down at about 25 kilometers here. So it's the plate interface. And so this whole area is prone to earthquakes. Right now beneath us is plate boundary. To the east, the Pacific plate is moving down towards the west here. So this whole plate is compressing the upper part of the crust, because right now on that plate boundary, the plate is locked. That means that it's accumulating some strain, and that strain is felt by this compression that we can feel in the crust. So if you look out to the east, you can see ranges, and that is part of the compression that we can see. At that plate boundary, we get a lot of faults, and because we get earthquakes on those faults, and we feel that because that tension has been locked up, that plate boundary may move in a big earthquake. Okay, so the instruments we're using are seismographs. We have 900 of these instruments across the body of the North Island. So again, from coast to coast, every instrument is spaced 100 meters apart. And so again, they're kind of like microphones, and we have a sound source, explosions. We have 12 of them. Those explosions generate wave energy that goes down into the crust and then is reflected back from that interface. And out of that, we get an image of the crust beneath the North Island. We're doing it in the dark because it's quieter in the dark. Traffic adds noise to the sensors, so that's to our array, that recording array. The idea is that we need to have it as still and as quiet as possible when we let off the shot. Okay, we're at
the end. That's you, Mark.
That's it, Mark.
3, 2, 1, fire the hole.
Okay, so we've just let off an explosion. It was just after 11 o'clock, so there was an initial boom and the ground shook. And then, consequently, there was a geyser, this gas escaping from the explosion. Shifted all of the stemming, all of the gravel that we had as backfill into the air. It was a phenomenal geyser. So the shot, the initial pulse, the bang, that was the initial bang. So we think that was a very successful shot. That's a pretty successful shot. The energy would have travelled, well, confidently to all the receivers on the array.